Sunday, the 2nd of January, and we're going to start parting out the small resistance X-Wing set. It consists of just two bags and one bigger piece and the manual. Already opened a brick store file for it. So now I'm going to get everything out of the box and get it sorted. When the part out is done, I need to do some administrative work as it's the end of a quarter and I need to get ready to give it to the tax authorities. So let's start the Sunday off with that. Set is all parted out. Not a lot of pieces, but the pieces that are there have a nice quantity of them, as I bought 10 sets, so that's really great. But came here for the minifigures to add them to the store. So now let's put them away and get it uploaded so we can get on with the administration. Today we are ticking off a lot of first of the years. We've just did the first part out of the year. Filled up the wall a bit, not too much. Forgot to turn around the door. And we've gotten the first order of the year. And this customer is going all black with the pieces. Thank you for the order, and I'll ship it tomorrow. Finished the administration. So we're good to go. As I was busy with the administration, we've gotten a breakout order. So, not a bad start of the year. Two orders today. It was paid with the IBAN payment methods, but for some reason it didn't show up in how do you call it, Brick Freedom, what I use to sync. So a bit annoyed, or a bit annoying, because now I don't pick in the order of the numbers. Brick Freedom does that really nice. It starts with one and ends at the highest number. And Brickall is a bit crisscross. So need to get a bit used to this. But we'll make it work. Someone is buying all the 2x4 bricks in bright pink. Didn't think that color would move really fast, but good to see it does. The drawer is stuck. Bought all of the dark turquoise bricks, lime 201, all of them. Medium lavender, also a color I didn't think would move fast or even at all. It's great to see they are moving. They were part of the one of the first sets I bought. Which had a few of those exotic colors. So always happy to see then move. 2, 4, 6, 7. Chips out. 79. 7 of these. Today's orders cleared out quite a few lots. So gets time to fill them up again. Oh. And buy some more sets. I'm expecting some sets on Tuesday, so we can fill the empty drawers up again. Pick the order. Now I'm going to pack it to fit it in the box and recount it and ship it in the morning. It's Monday, the 3rd of January, and we've gotten a small Brickall order. Let's see if I can pull it off with one hand. It's just two of the brown spares. Oops. Quite a small order, but every order counts. Thank you for the order. And we'll ship it tomorrow. It's Tuesday, the 4th of January, and we've gotten three of the French set I ordered last week. It's a pretty big set, and last time I told in the vlog that I should wait with bigger sets until the weekend, but I just can't help myself. If there's a new set, I need to part it out to get the parts in the store. As for French sets in general, I think this will be one of the last ones, as well as the video, as it has some pretty exotic pieces and colors. And I think I should be focusing more on the generic colors a bit, so I get more pieces of the faster selling kind. But for now, let's start with these three big sets. It has some sticker pieces, some cloth pieces, and a ton of bags, and some roller coaster pieces. Well, where have I gotten myself into this time? I hope I can finish this all in one night. But we'll see. We'll put on some music and enjoy the part out. I really like doing part outs. I think they are a bit calming and relaxing, so even though it's a bit much, it doesn't feel like a chore to me. Let's go. As with all big sets, I'm struggling with space and with the amount of cups I have. But I've gone for a new strategy, as in I will stack the cups by color, and when they are full, I'll take the brick store file and go through the colors and see which I can put away. In previous part outs, I always mixed the colors all over the place, so that wasn't efficient. Now, as I sort out black, for instance, I just take those three stacks and put them right there and go through them fast and easy. And if they still need parts in them, I'll put them back. Just wanted to share that. Maybe some of you benefit from it. Part out is done.
We've added 188 new lots. Gonna notify the members. And then let's check our store and the lot count. We've hit 38,000 lots, 38,000 items, and almost at 3,000 lots. Nice progress for evening of work. And as far as the wall goes, we filled 1.5 of the new drawers, so still got 7.5 left. So time to get some more Lego. All in all, great progress today. So I added some glow in the dark tiles and I just turned off the light and it looks really cool. Thought I would share it with you. Check it out. At night, one drawer lights up in the room. So cool. It's Wednesday, the 5th of January. It's a bit late night, but over the course of the day, we've gotten two orders. One Brickau order, which is clearing out most of my dark bluish gray tiles. Huge quantities there. And a Bricklink order of a repeat customer for some Harry Potter minifigure parts. Repeat customer is always great to see, because that means we're doing something right. Thank you both for the order. And we'll ship it in the morning. It's Thursday, the 6th of January. We've gotten a Bricklink order. Another small order, this time for some red and dark red pieces. Two left. So quite an easy one. The order is all picked. And small recount, as I'm not good at doing two things at a time. And then we'll get it packed. And as always, shipped in the morning. It's Friday, the 7th of January. And we've gotten the Dymo labels. So we can finish off labeling the new drawers. And another task for today will be to break down this train and get it listed and uploaded. Should add some nice new lots and train parts in general always do pretty good. So can't wait to add them to the store. And maybe even after break down the Star Wars set. Don't know yet. As for other things, I'm kind of looking on marketplaces and such for used sets. I'm looking to buy one lot, so I get some experience with it and see what's a good value or price for a kilograms of Lego. As I don't really have experience with it, I don't really know what to pay for a kilogram, but yeah, it's a learning experience. So if the first one isn't that profitable,
I'll consider it as a learning experience and we'll see what we can pick up. The train set is all broken down, ready to be parted out later this week, as I'm having a quite busy weekend ahead. I don't know if I have the time to part out such a big set, but at least it's broken down for now. And soon we'll have to get on with labeling the drawers. It's Saturday, the 8th of January, and later this day I'm expecting some new sets, a small Lego haul. As of right now, I'm adding some round tiles to the store. Later, some of the bushings. And I see my MacBook is running out of juice. So, up. Yeah, don't have a lot of time today, but wanted to do some small work and get some used parts in the store. With that small upload of used parts, we've hit a new milestone. 3,000 lots in the store. I expect to have room to grow to almost 4,000 lots. So that's the next goal. Really great progress for the first week of the year. Last clip of this week. We've gotten the package I mentioned before. And it contains 5 of the Harry Potter Hogwarts Polyjuice Potion Mistake. So the Harry Potter figures went really well, so decided to buy some more and add them to the store. I will be parting them out tomorrow probably. So yeah, that's the end of the week. As always, thank you for watching and see you next week. Bye bye.